you'll be able to send videos and texts to 911 dispatchers, and they will know exactly where you're calling from. The new system could launch in the next 5 years. Our Amanda Quintana is here with more on the plan. Amanda?
Yes, that's right. This new system is still, like you said, about 5 years away, but the State Department of Military Affairs believes it could help people in crisis who are in a situation where they can't call or make noise, or they're having a medical emergency where first responders are needed as soon as possible.
We live in an age where there's an app for everything, and for many, their cell phone feels like a part of them. But it could take first responders longer to get to you if you use it to call 911.
Most of the time, it comes back the tower that the phone is pinging off of, yes, which really, it could be within miles of where the person is.
Wisconsin's 911 system will soon enter the digital age, upgrading to next-gen 911 with more bandwidth to allow dispatch centers to pinpoint the exact location of a caller and even receive texts.
If a citizen sees a crime in progress, they can actually take pictures of it, or they can send a video back to the dispatcher. In turn, the dispatcher can send that to the squads that are responding to the scene.
Tom Chaya says only 7 counties offer the texting service currently, but they can't locate callers. This system would be offered to the more than 100 dispatch centers. He says the deaf community and people experiencing domestic abuse are just some of many Wisconsinites who would benefit, but not everyone is convinced.
Fear paralyzed people. If they're too scared to make that phone call, they're not going to text you. They're not, let alone send a picture.
Veronica Figueroa is the executive director of Unidos, an organization aiming to break the cycle of domestic violence. They run a 24-hour crisis line in Spanish. She wishes the state would focus on language access before texting.
You don't have the capability in your staff to understand or interpret what I'm trying to say. How is that going to help people?
Chaya says the system won't break down the language barrier, but the time it saves will be life-changing.
The most recent state budget included $6.7 million for planning this upgrade. Now the state is waiting on bids from vendors who can create this system, with cost included in the 2019 biennium budget.
Very interesting. We'll continue to follow it. Thanks,
Thank
Amanda.
You.